About the community discourse, which is found in Matthew 18, which is about how a community should live together. And then he also spoke about the parable discourse, which is found in Matthew 13. And he made mention about saying to it that you do not base your interpretation on the title, because the title, the titles of the different genre or the different literature, forms of literature that found in the Bible was only written later, including the number of the chapters and the verses. That is why, as a scholar, he advocates that you should read it directly, without the chapters, without the titles, because sometimes the titles can be misleading. To be able to find the substance of that of what you are reading, you have to read the context. So what he emphasized basically here is there is a context to a text. So in scholarship, they speak about the text behind the text in front of the text as is, you know. So our evening praise will have to do with a Bible text, one of the Bible texts that he has given us. So in church history, you have learned about praying with scripture, praying with scripture. So this will take only a short time because it will only deal with simple things. The things that you learn here, do not pass it on to your people as is. You have to interpret that and reinterpret that according to the mindset of the people and according to their level of understanding. Otherwise, you confuse them. One of the scholars told me, Nati, there was a question in my class, and I said, what was that question? Sabi nila, do you come here to destroy our faith? So I said, I think the question was asked because sa kabubusisi natin sa mga ano text and the context and all the words and the verbs, etc., na wala na yung substance. As Father said yesterday, there are only two words that have been surely said by Jesus, and that is Abba and Amen. All the rest. Okay, so you know, of course, it was mentioned yesterday, and rightfully so, that there are three stages of tradition. The first stage of tradition is the life and words of Jesus on this earth, okay, particularly in Palestine. The second tradition after the resurrection is the oral tradition. It has been preached, what they heard about Jesus and what Jesus has taught to people. It has been preached orally, and people memorized that. That is why they were able to tell and retell and retell. But in the retelling, there was an adaptation regarding the culture as well as the language as well as the situation of the people. Now what Father mentioned by them was that sits im leben, which means to say the situation of life of people of that time. What was the situation of life of the Matean community? There was persecution, there was suffering, there was exclusion, and so on and so forth. And that brought about the Matean writing about this part, which is about the Beatitudes. And Father said that you, and you have learned that also in your spiritual classes, there's only one Beatitude, blessed are the poor, and all the rest are explaining what is it to be poor. In Matthew, it is poor in spirit, but of course in Luke, it is poor, talagang destitute, no? But that is another course. because when you speak about the Bible is very interesting because when you find an answer to one question, it leads you to another question, and you keep on digging and digging and digging. That is why in Jerusalem, they call that archaeological digging of the text. You have to dig and dig and dig. Ano bang ibig sabihin ng text na ito? So you have witnessed that he said, well, that is one interpretation. This is another interpretation. This is my first time to hear about the soul. I never heard about the soul. I heard only about the soil, but not the soul, you know. But I was interested, so the that is another interpretation. And that is what I like in Jerusalem, because there are different rabbinic interpretations, and you could choose what kind of interpretation you resonate with. Anyway, so there were many things that were brought up, so we will concentrate on Matthew 5. No, Matthew 5. It has been said, but now I tell you. It has been said, but now I tell you. Why did Father talk about the situation in life of that time? Because it is for us to see to it, how does this apply now to us in our time? So we speak also of the seeds im Leben now. What is the seeds im Leben now? We mentioned about it. There is corruption, there is political disagreement, so many things and so on. There are so many things happening in our country, which is not different from what was happening in the Matean community, so to speak. Now, how did he try to reappropriate that for us? He's telling us back to the sources, like Father said yesterday, back to the sources, back to your identity as a Christian. What is your identity as a Christian? If this is your identity as a Christian, what will be your response to the situation that is happening in the here and now in our respective parishes? All right. So yan po ang ating panilayan ngayon. So our evening praise will take the form of a mini Biblia Nilay. I call it Biblia Nilay, but that is an invention. Biblia, and then Pagninilay. So Biblia Nilay. Actually, the process is Lectio Divina. But I abbreviated it to be applicable for families and for people who are always in a hurry. So, Father yesterday, Monsignor yesterday mentioned about doctrine, moral, worship. He mentioned about prayer, about action, response, and about the message. So that is what we're going to do today. First, we're going to have the opening prayer, that is reflection. So reflection dance. Reflection, actually that is not a dance. It's only, when you speak about new evangelization, we have to speak about what he mentioned, new methodologies, a new fervor. New fervor means to say it has to show in your face. You know, the joy of the resurrection has to radiate in your face. By the way, the resurrection is my dissertation here in De La Salle, and it is for religious educators. So you have to see this in the library. The resurrection and its implications for religious education. What is really the resurrection? Kasi ang sinabi ni Father, what are the effects of the resurrection? Pero what is it? What is it? And then the president, your brother, said, right about the resurrection. I said, why? Why about the resurrection? Sabi niya, because Jackie is still looking up. As in, Jesus is still dead. So, okay. So that was my dissertation here. The resurrection and its implications for religious education. So, may mga outmoded na doon. But, my advisor told me to use 1 Corinthians 15, 35-58. And I said, why Paul? Why not the Synoptic Gospels? And he said, because Paul was the first to write about the resurrection. That is why, if you want to have a little idea of what the resurrection is, according to the Pauline thought, that is in 1 Corinthians 15, 35-58. Of course, there are more. So we will have the reflection dance. After the reflection dance, reflective dance, we will have the opening prayer. And after the opening prayer, we will read the text. Everybody, do you have your Bibles? Everybody, open to Matthew 5. Matthew 5. Read the text. And then the next is understand the text. How do you understand the text? Ask questions. So it is no more, oh, choose a word that tells you something and then hear about that. According to scholars, choosing a word, choosing a verse right away, that is the word of man. And we're talking about the word of God. So we first try to understand the text. What is the text saying? You don't need to be a scholar to understand that. You ask questions about the text. From your questions, you try to come up with a particular course of action. What will be your action in relation to that reflection on what you understood here? And after the action, we have the closing prayer. O di ba, 10 minutes lang, okay na yan. Ito po ay ginagawa ng mga madre na pupupunta sa bahay-bahay. This is done by sisters in a particular area in Manila. They go from house to house. But the mother said, oh, I have to wash clothes. Oh, I have to do this. Oh, I still have to wash my, I still have to fetch my child. So the sister said, no, 10 minutes only. It's only like this. Alright. We have been talking about our identity. So what is our identity? So we will do the reflection thus in relation to St. Francis of Assisi. Oh, Signore. Oh, Signore. Padine. Un instrumentum della tua patria. So we will do that north, south, east, west. It has been said, do not commit adultery, but now I tell you, any man who looks at a woman with evil intentions in his mind has already committed adultery. Then do not divorce. And then yung reconciliation, alright? So you choose from any of that which father meant. Let us prepare ourselves for our evening prayer.
Thank you.
down and face your partner. Sit down.